Rob Nelson here, and we wanted to introduce you to some of the science of the Olympics.
We are here to look at altitude. Why do athletes train at altitude?
Altitude training minimum above 5,000 feet.
And to do that, we are here in Colorado Springs. It's the home of the Olympic training facility at 6,000 feet. And if you can see behind me, we have Pikes Peak. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna climb up the top and see how our bodies are adapted to the altitude right now. Let's go.
The heart of your blood, all around your body, bringing it the stuff that it needs. The blood goes through the lungs to get some oxygen and bring it around so your body can breathe.
Here, camera. What do you think it is about the altitude that helps athletes train?
I think because it strengthens their lungs so much.
And what is it about the thinner atmosphere?
Just like you adjust your lungs to less air.
I think it allows your lungs to open up more. Maybe you get a better wind when you're out here because you have to force yourself to have to breathe out here and run. And then when you go there and it's thicker and the air is more moist, maybe it gives you more air and moisture in your lungs, maybe.
Contrary to popular belief, it doesn't really have anything to do with our lungs.
Right. I honestly, I don't know. I just kind of go along with that.
So maybe like the oxygen is higher at sea level.
Yeah.
Then that's what we need.
For
oxygen.
Sure.
Yeah.
Oxygen.
To understand what's happening to our bodies at altitude, let's review how our body uses oxygen.
We breathe in air. It has oxygen in it. Our lungs help pass the oxygen to our blood. Our blood passes the oxygen to our tissues. At high altitudes, there's less oxygen, meaning less oxygen in the blood and less oxygen gets into the muscles. Thus, we feel winded. So, our body compensates by creating more red blood cells. If we go down in altitude, those extra red blood cells then can carry even more oxygen to our tissues.
So why is it then that everybody thinks that when you're at altitude, your lungs are the things that are strengthened? I mean, it makes sense. You think, the lungs are part of the system that transfers oxygen to our body, and it's the one thing I feel when I go to altitude.
Not far at all from where we started. We're already really winded.
So the one thing that does happen is that our bodies sense the lower amount of oxygen. We have special little cells in our kidneys, and they then release the hormone EPO. That hormone triggers the release of more red blood cells. So now you have flowing through your body more red blood cells, and every red blood cell carries oxygen with it to your tissues. So very simply, the more red blood cells you have, the more easily the body can transfer oxygen to your tissues. Now, if you were at high altitude and then you go down to lower elevation, you basically have the ability for a very short amount of time to get more oxygen to your muscles. The trick is that it only lasts about 15 days. So there's some controversy as to whether or not altitude training is actually all that beneficial, because it does take a lot of time to get used to the altitude. In fact, is that it takes about 11.4 days per 1,000 meters. Okay, but remember, this whole issue is a little bit complicated, and we reviewed the whole thing here on our website if you want to learn more. We'll be doing more of these Science of the Olympics in the future. Stay tuned. So if you enjoyed that, like us.